Hey Angular folks, it's Brian. Most Angular developers know about ViewChild, but many don't know about its secret weapon, the read parameter. In this tutorial, I'll show you how with it, you can unlock completely different scenarios inside your component. By the end, you'll not only understand what read does, you'll be using it to write cleaner, more powerful Angular code. Let's check it out. Here's the app we'll be working with in this tutorial. It's a simple Angular component that's going to be used to demonstrate the read parameter in the view child signal query. Now, if you've never heard of the read parameter, don't worry. Many Angular developers haven't, and that's exactly why I'm making this. So right now, this thing is pretty boring. We've got a box with some text and a button that doesn't do anything yet. But by the end of this video, this single element is going to demonstrate four completely different ways we can access it from our component code. Okay, let's switch over to the code and open up the template for this component. The first thing we see here is this div with a template reference variable named reference. This is the box that we saw in the browser. This div also has a highlight directive applied to it as well. Below that, we have an ng template, and notice it also has that same reference variable too. Inside it, there's a div with some template content. Now, ng template is Angular's way of defining a chunk of HTML that doesn't render by default. It's like having a blueprint that we can use later. And finally, we have our button that calls a function called run when clicked. Now, here's where it gets interesting. Both the template and the div have the same reference name. In most cases, this would be confusing, and in the real world, you probably wouldn't do this. But here, I've done this on purpose to illustrate the utility of ViewChild's read parameter. Now, let's switch to our component TypeScript file and start adding some code. Right now, our component is pretty empty. It just has an empty run function, so let's fix that. We want to access the element from our template. So how do we do that? Well, with the viewChild function, of course. Then we pass this function a selector. In this case, it's our reference template variable. So this will find any element in our template with the reference variable. Now, so that we can visualize this, let's add some logic to our run method. I'm just going to check if the viewChild exists, and if it does, I'll log it out. Okay, let's save this and see what happens now in the browser. Let's click the Run Demo button. Perfect, look at that console log. We can see that we have an element ref. And when we hover over the element, we can see that it's the div element here. This is because Angular gave us an element ref pointing to the div element. But here's the thing, this is just happening by luck. Angular looked at our template, found two things with the reference name, and just picked one. In this case, it probably just picked the div because it came first in our HTML. Let me show you why. Let's go back to our component template and move the ng template above the div. I'll cut this template and paste it at the top. Now let's save and test again. Okay, let me click the button again. Look at that. Now we're getting a template ref instead of an element ref. Angular found the template first this time, so that's what it gave us. Okay, let's switch back over and move the ng template back where it was. This concept just demonstrates that ViewChild's default behavior is unreliable when you have multiple elements with the same reference name. But here's where the read parameter changes things. Let's go back to our component TypeScript file and change this a little. Now I'm going to modify our viewChild to be explicit about what we want. Let's add an options parameter to the viewChild, and within it, let's add the read property. We'll pass this property an element ref. So now we're telling Angular, I specifically want the element ref from the element with this reference name, no guessing required. This makes our code much more predictable and maintainable. Now I know exactly what I'm getting, regardless of how my template might change in the future. Now, I want to actually do something with this element ref. I'm going to add a CSS class to change the appearance of our div. But To safely manipulate the DOM in Angular, I need to inject the renderer2 service. Renderer2 is Angular's safe way to manipulate the DOM. It works in all environments, including server-side rendering, unlike direct DOM manipulation. Now, we'll use the renderer to add a CSS class called highlighted to our element. I've already defined this class in the styles to make our box yellow when applied. Let's save and test this out now. Okay, let's click the button. Perfect. Notice how the box changed to yellow? That's our highlighted CSS class being applied. And in the console, we're getting an element ref, just like we'd expect. Now, order still matters here. Let's switch over and move the template back before the div. Okay, let's save and see what happens now. Let's click the button again. Okay, now we get an error. This is because we're trying to add a class to a comment element inserted from the ng template now, which we can't do. So just keep this in mind when using ViewChild. Okay, let's move the template back again. Now here's where things get a little interesting. The same element can give us completely different capabilities depending on what we ask for with the read parameter. Let's add another ViewChild property for the same reference, but this time asking for a ViewContainerRef. Now, you may be asking yourself, what's a ViewContainerRef? Think of it as a content injection point. It's like having a container where you can dynamically add components, templates, or other content at runtime. It's incredibly powerful for building dynamic UIs. Now, let's add a condition for this and then add a console log if it exists. We'll do more with this in a minute, but for now, let's use the renderer again to add a class to this div using the view container this time. This will show that we can access the same element through different reference types. Okay, now let's save and try this out. Let's click the button again. Excellent. Now our div still has the yellow background, and now it has a dotted border too. That border change comes from the hasContent class that we just added. And look at the console. We now have both an ElementRef and a ViewContainerRef logged out, both pointing to the same DOM element but giving us different capabilities. Now, let's do more with this ViewContainerRef. I mentioned earlier that we have a template with the same reference name. We can use the ViewContainerRef to dynamically inject that template content into our div. First, I need to get access to that ng template. Let's add another ViewChild property, this time with a TemplateRef for the read parameter. So in this case, even though our div and template have the same reference name, Angular will give us the template because that's specifically what we're asking for with the read parameter. Okay, now let's add some logic for this in our run method. Then we'll log out the TemplateRef. And now, here's the cool part. Let's use that ViewContainerRef we created earlier to inject this template content into our div. This line takes the template, creates an embedded view from it, then injects it into the container. So we're taking the content from our ng template and dynamically inserting it into our div. Let's save and see this in action. Let's click the button. Whoa, look at that. Our div now has additional content that was dynamically injected from our ng template. And in the console, we now have all three reference types logged: ElementRef for DOM manipulation, ViewContainerRef for content injection, and TemplateRef for the template itself. This is incredibly powerful for building dynamic interfaces. But wait, there's more. Remember that highlight directive on our div? We can get direct access to that directive instance too. Let's add one more ViewChild property. This time, we'll ask for the highlight directive instance. This gives us direct access to the directive's methods and properties. Okay, now let's add some logic for this in our run method. And then let's add a console log for this too. Okay, let's save one more time and try this out. Let's click the button. Perfect. Now we have all four reference types in our console. And when we take a closer look at the directive log, we can see the highlight directive instance. This means we could call methods on the directive, change its properties, or interact with it programmatically. So there you have it, the viewChild read parameter. This is one of those Angular features that's incredibly powerful, but criminally underused. Here's what you need to remember. The read parameter lets you get exactly what you need from any template reference. ElementRef for DOM manipulation, ViewContainerRef for dynamic content, TemplateRef for template access, and any directive for whatever you need from it. One reference, several superpowers, same element, completely different capabilities. If this blew your mind, hit that like button and subscribe for more hidden Angular gems. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.